Hello and welcome to New Hope for Today. My name is Pastor Andrew Hise, and I'm the pastor at New Hope Friends Church in Goldsboro, North Carolina. You know, something that we always do during this week of the year, Thanksgiving week, is we prepare for special days that we've set aside for this celebration. We prepare even today on this Wednesday. We prepare for Thanksgiving Day, a special day we've set aside to give thanks for all of the blessings we have in our life, to be thankful. I think even a month from today, we're already preparing, maybe some of you are, for Christmas Day, a day that we've set aside as a special day to celebrate the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. There are lots of special days that we have throughout the year, and we call these holidays. And that simply comes from the term holy days. It's just a smushed up version of that. And holy means to set it apart. And that's what these days are. They're days that are set apart for a celebration or of some kind of thing. So Thanksgiving, thankfulness, Christmas, Jesus' birth. We think about 4th of July and Independence Day in America. We set aside that day to celebrate our freedoms here in America. Or Easter, we set aside to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. These are all holy days or holidays in our year, special days. You know, another special day that each of us individually have through our year calendar is our birthday. And my birthday always happens to fall right around Thanksgiving. And so I'm reminded again of that special day. And some of us, I think, believe our birthday should be a holiday. We should not have to do anything special on our birthday. But it's also a special day that we set aside. And anniversaries are the same way. We set aside those days to celebrate our marriages, our relationships. And I have a confession to make to you today. And some of you already know this about me. I actually have never really liked these special days. I don't know what it is. My birthday normally comes around every year, and I'm normally working on my birthday, doing something that I am forced to do, something that I have to do. I've just never made a really big deal about my birthday, at least since I've been out of my parents' house. Same thing with Thanksgiving and Christmas. I even all of these holidays, I just see them as other days. But as you probably know about me, I married someone who has the exact opposite view. In fact, when her birthday comes around each year, she, instead of saying it's just her birthday, she tries to go for a month. Now, I've gotten her down to a week, a birthday week, but she really looks forward to these special days, these holidays, these holy days that are set aside. And maybe through her, through being married to her, or maybe through other things, I've come to actually over the years appreciate more and more these days that we have set aside, these holidays, the birthdays and all these different things. I think it may have been her, but I also think it's because of conviction I've come to from the scripture. You know, God set up many holy days, days that are to be remembered, set apart for remembering certain things. Passover, that was a feast. It was a long feast. It wasn't just one day, but there was a Passover day, right, where they would remember, the people of Israel would remember the day that they put the blood on the doorpost and the angel passed over. This was a remembering day. And just like God did in the Old Testament, Jesus also set up a special thing for us to remember certain things. And he does this, Paul talks about this in 1 Corinthians chapter 11. In verse 23 says this, "For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he also took the cup after supper, saying, 'This is the cup of the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.'" Now, of course, most of us would recognize this as Jesus' institution of what we call the Lord's Supper or communion, Eucharist for some of us with higher church backgrounds. But this is a special thing where we come together, a special ceremony where we eat bread and drink grape juice or wine, and we break the bread and we give thanks and we remember Jesus' death. But I think that Jesus, I absolutely believe Jesus here is instituting the Lord's Supper, but I also think he's wanting us to, any time we sit down to eat, any time that we break bread, so to speak, any time we take the cup, that we should remember Jesus' death. We remember lots of things on these holy days, on these special days, but do we remember every single time we sit down for a meal, Jesus' death and his sacrifice for us? I think God is calling us to that. This day, as you sit down to your meals, as you have your breakfast, your lunch, your dinner, before you do, I think most of us probably give thanks for it. But give thanks and remember again, meditate on the fact that Jesus died for you. And I think as we do that, it'll bring a special meaning to our meals and a special meaning to these holidays, these days that we set aside to remember certain things. Blessings to you. New Hope for Today is a daily video devotional brought to you by Pastor Andrew Hise of New Hope Friends Church. New Hope Friends Church is located at 4451 U.S. Highway 70 East in Goldsboro, North Carolina. New Hope for Today, Strength for Today, Hope for Tomorrow.